What's up, guys? Jimmy Rakowski, welcome back. And yesterday I put up a video talking about score streaks getting buffed in the latest update, which is actually live, but we don't have any official patch notes or anything or update notes about it from Treyarch. So it's kind of a, you have to go in and see what is different. And I have some updates for you guys, and I want you guys to give me feedback on what you've done as well. I'm going to close on my new house today, so I jumped into a custom game with bots and wanted to go over a few things. First of all, the lightning strike seems to deploy way quicker now. I don't have an actual timer on it, but I saw that on Twitter and I tried out in this game, and it does seem to, from the point when you call it in to the point where it actually deploys, it seems to be quicker. So you guys let me know what you think about that. The big things are, the hater did receive a buff. We can confirm that, and I'm gonna show you guys here in a minute when we get toward the end of this footage. I'm actually gonna put it on a timer and show you guys. Also, the Wraith is now harder to lock onto. I believe that you cannot lock onto it now with a launcher when it's cloaked. You guys can prove me wrong or right on that. Obviously, I didn't have an enemy to lock on. I deployed it myself, and we're gonna look at it here in a second. And if you're not familiar with the Wraith up until this point, it also has a little flak drone that follows it around, and you guys will see that in the footage here in a minute. And it will actually take out, it's like a trophy system from Black Ops 2, and it will intercept rockets, but it doesn't do anything to do with the dart or hailstorm. So those are ways to take out the Wraith as well. And I've also heard that the dart now has an enemy lock-on that you guys can actually use for that, which makes it a lot better as well. Now, the big thing I want to talk about is the hater and everybody, what everybody wanted in terms of a buff for the hater or the VSAT, whatever you want to call it, was the fact that it can be shot down, and everybody wants that gone. They think, and I agree, that the hater should be unshootable. It's a high orbital satellite, so you shouldn't even be able to see it with a launcher from the ground. Not that this is anything to do with real life, but the point was that you earned it and you got the full capacity of it. Well, that's not the case. You can still shoot down the hater, but it did receive a buff. It went from being in the air for 30 seconds to being in the air for plus 40 seconds. And as you guys can see on the screen, the second I initiated the hater, I started a timer on the bottom right of the screen. We're also looking at the Wraith here. You guys can get a good look of it with its little flak drone there. And everybody is saying it's way harder to shoot down now because when it's cloaked, you actually can't lock onto it, which would make the Wraith really, really good. It was already good, but if you can't lock onto it while it's cloaked and only while it's shooting, then that's going to make it even beefier. But the big one is the hater. As you can see, we're at 30 seconds with the hater deployed now. We're still going. It looks like it's added 10 seconds. It's actually about 12 seconds because the time it actually completely fades out with no triangles, it's at 43 seconds, almost 43 and a half seconds that the hater was up in the air. So that is a big buff. It's not what we wanted. We wanted where you couldn't shoot it down, but to add 10 to 12 seconds to it in deployment, that's pretty cool. So let me know what you guys think. That's what I've seen so far. Let me know about the mothership. What's the buff on the mothership and anything else that you guys have experienced yourself? I'll keep you guys updated myself if I come across anything else, and I'll see you guys later.